Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I've been putting over 2,000 YouTube videos on Christianity, Sikhism, and Islam. So I have learned this subject from my late father, and he had written quite a few articles and other thing, information. And I will try to put it on this internet, YouTube. So this is the first writing of my father, and it will explain his approach to the study of religion, which was very scientific. And that's how I learned the subject of Christianity, Sikhism, and everything. So here is the first one, which is got the video here, the text here, and bear with me. He wrote on the four ages, the concept of four ages. And here is how he tackled the problem. Concept of four ages. Now he said, history repeats itself, means that the circle, you can call circle or cycle, it's the same thing, he used the word circle. Four ages is repeated again and again. Now in India, you know, we believe that there are four ages according to the four qualification, religious qualification. Three are religious qualification light, one is the base. So accordingly, there are four ages. And this age is 109th circle, which will last for a few decades more when 110th circle will begin with the age of Satyug, which the Jehovah's witnesses. Witnesses who are true contented and merciful will begin to rule. My father's concept of Jehovah's Witnesses was that they are contented people and they are merciful people. And he says that when the new Satyug begins, then people will have conscience, which is the base of spirituality. Then they should be truthful, contented, and merciful. So these are the three qualities and one base of the religion. So when all the three qualities of religion, the light, are intact, and the base is of course there, then we call the age is called Satyug. Satyug means a age of a saint. Everybody is a Bhagat, or he is a perfect man. At present, there is a famine of truth. Famine means that truth is very hard to find. People tell lies mostly, especially in democratic rule. Democratic, as this is Britain, is under democracy and other. People are hypocrite. They don't speak the truth, they tell lie. So common man speak the truth sometime, but not these politicians. Politicians are supposed to be the responsible people, because there is a famine of truth, especially in democratic rule, because the ruling parties and even religious preachers of today, that is Kalyug, do not talk in terms of identification. You know, the person, when you talk, you know, you should talk in terms of identification. Identification is one that doesn't change. And that identification that does not change is your natal selves. Natal, N-A-T-A-L, natal selves. That means by birth, or the tribal self, which we call caste. This number of circles are four edges. So in each circle, there are four edges, you know, is denoted by the number of beads in a semirni, or that is called rosary. So the rosary represents the number of beads that the circle of those edges. Used to note the number of recitation of the name of God in different languages. So people recite, you know, the name of God, Ram Ram or Allah Allah, whatever you can call. But the rosary of the Mohammedans has 99 and one big bead, which is of Allah, at the 100th. Remember the story of Jesus finding 99 sheep? When he found the one which was fat, which was missing, he loved it the most. Now the number of beads is 109, and when the new age begins, this number will become 110. So these are rosary beads. In Satyug, that means when all the three religious qualities are intact, all the three qualifications, truth, contentment and mercy will prevail, along with the foundation of shame or conscience. So conscience or shame, which is the salt of the earth, will prevail, which is attributed mostly to the natal selves. Shame, you know, or conscience, normally to the natal selves. That is why the John baptized the men in water in the name of Abraham, the establishing their natal selves, or covenant with Abraham, making them the salt of the earth. So that is called conscience or shame. So if you have no shame or conscience, you cannot be truthful, contented and merciful. When mercy disappears, the people begin to attack women unjustifiable, and the next age begins. Remember that the women, the men start to think that they are their chattel, so they can treat them as they like, sell them, buy them, and like anything, you know. So they maltreat the woman. So they become cruel to women, because they can't become cruel to the other men, they will beat them, you know. But the women, they are the only victims of their cruelty. This age, next one, this age is known as TRETA. TRETA means three-legged age in India, TRETA. When contentment also disappears, the new age begins. It is known as DOAPAR. So when the contentment also goes, then you have a DOAPAR. In the TRETA age, you have three qualities: shame, truth, and contentment. So when the contentment disappears, then there are left two: shame and truth. Two is called DOAPAR, means two qualities. It is known as DOAPARs in India. Karo, the rulers, did not agree to give even 5 villages to their 5 Pandu cousins, whose father ruled as guardian of Karos till the elder Karo became adult. Now there's a story of Mahabharata, we call it. And in that one, there's a fight between Kauru and Pandu. So there were two cousins, and the father of the Pandus, he looked after the cousins of Pandus, Kauru's they were known, but those Kauru's, they did not felt the obligation which the father of Pandus has given to them. So they were so unthankful because they were once-born people. So once-born people sometimes, you know, they go, they don't consider anything. They just are, become egoistic and jealous. So they want to see the other person to be ruined, not to be flourishing. It is in Christianity that we treat everyone alike, whether he is your friend or foe. Whose father ruled as guardian of Kauru till the elder Kauru became adult, when truth also begins to disappear. So when people don't speak the truth even, it becomes a Kalyug. Kalyug is the present age. So in this present age, the light that was the leftover, last bit of light, truth, that disappears. Only people have either salt of the earth or they are saltless. Saltless are those who have no conscience. Salt, people of the salt are those who have conscience or the tribal integrity. They are shame of their natal selves. In this age, polluted truth and falsehoods prevail. Polluted truth is like somebody getting discount on his, when he buys the thing, but when he want to sell it, he will tell the customer, oh, look, I'm selling you at the cost price. But he won't tell that he has got a discount on that goods. So that is called polluted truth, in which you don't tell the truth, but you hide it. That is also called hypocrisy and falsehoods. Trade secrets pollute the truth, that is the trade secret, no discount and other thing. And talking in common terms make falsehood. So people talk in common terms like Congress, Communist, Labour, Conservative. They are not any, they don't represent any natal self or tribal selves. So they are not the real political party, they are falsehood. False created parties. They are called abstract lies. Even the religious places have been polluted by giving out falsehoods which cannot be detected by the simpletons or the once born people and fanatics. The simpletons are fanatics, so they do not understand what the politicians are talking. In democratic rules, the ruling parties are trying to do away with the tribes, without which you cannot make a true statement. So in India, you know, the people want to get rid of the tribe. They think it's an evil, but without tribe, you are not identified. So I am a son of a Jat. So if I do away with my tribe Jat, then I won't be able to identify Nijjar is the son, is the subcaste of Jats. So if I'm Nijjar, so I'm revealing my tribe. But in India said, oh, no, don't put that one even. Make it disappear. In India, the column of tribe has been deleted in official records, but the police always ask the culprit their tribes to deal with them according to their hereditary character. Moreover, every sensible person wants to know the tribe and caste of the boy before making engagement of his daughter. So the owners of this age will utterly fail to do away with the tribe, which is the name of one's political father. This age will come to an end when the people begin to talk collectively. especially political fame, in terms of identification tribes. Then we will again, Satyug will become when unpolluted truth will prevail to bring contentment and mercy as well. Unpolluted truth can have some exceptions, which are very few otherwise. It always conforms with the abstract truth, which is spiritual principle or His word. God bless you.